Among the tattered dwelling is a newfound home. In the furthest cramped corner sat the shell of a goat head. Strangled in copper wire, scraped of its insides, unwashed behind the ears, seeming a crooked name spoken in hinges. To a thinning cowlick spat his crippled limb, dragging along the hump of the floor, sobbing from the smacking mouth of the Denimon Wells, making wise cracks, spilling from the corners with their pink flinches, second glancing their every move. It ate pickled nose cartilage that fell from the ceilings, a pork skin drizzle unnerving the humans. While it read aloud from his favorite books, in glossolalia slang, and house truths, the following swayed patiently, unlocking their hair as it was glued to their upper lip comb over. Under the wall, the shit sneered by faithfully taunting the nagging fanatics and their bottles of scalp soup. They cooked up a tar to smudge on their eyes, a lunar anodyne powdered underneath the oncoming pestilence of their vibrating fingers. It broke in the seance, penetrated their every dependent desire. It hacked off the central headpiece to the collective. It wrote them a message in the marrow of the knife, with the extension of Baphomet transfusion. Glued to the animals, perversions of their former selves, patiently biting their fingernails looking for a clue. As soon as it failed to appear, the faithful felon dispelled public execution. It had been an eternity filled with useless ritual, all for nothing, promising salvation, but only flies came spawning around for a better taste. What was left were the scraps, dressed in animal skin, defiled servants holding their breath, fatherless culprits blaming their kin, waiting for an answer. They thought a day would come, or a draft might check in mid-air squeal, some sort of indication. Only it was the hands of their followers that had left their mark in the neatly packed dunes filled with the decapitated remains, found sealed in sand. It only stained the conscience for a brief moment, then came disgust. Realizing there was nothing to it, people began collapsing in collective states of drought. Palm-sized vents heaving in the chest,
cluttering the breath,
cluttering the bladder full of mates. Nothing became of them because nothing was the reason. An apathetic display dripping into vats of obesity. The feud had been sucking teeth for some time now, but the only baggage that lingered about was the curtain of the nurse, unfolded in an inebriated suit. The fit came suffocated, feathering hollow constricted paleness, frostbitten, the shock of haste. It came before them in utter confidence. Flares of pink gouts in the midst of albino eyelids blinking out chemical obscurities
to the blind.
Bloomed into a hemorrhage contraption that impopulated the disenchanted one by one. All the churches were converted into quarantine facilities. Inside them grew bacterial cells that were acted by larvae and contracted the tumor. The inborn litter degraded insufficient. Running from the horse collarbone, amongst the murmuring femurs whimpering in fractures. All over them. Sigh of relief steamed off the
mascara glass in the mobile weeds. Her ash, a serpent infancy. Set foot inside a parlor.